Hello, welcome. In today's video, we'll explore one of the Switch exclusives, a game I had never experienced before. By dedicating time to play it and create this content, I must confess that I enjoyed Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 quite a bit. This game has had some issues in the past, but currently it's playable on both projects. Additionally, there's a mod available to achieve 60 FPS in the game. If you're curious to find out which is the best emulator to run this game, stick with us until the end of the video.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
In general, Koei's games often pose challenges on Yuzu and Ryujinx, and PC ports sometimes come with questionable quality. Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 hasn't reached perfection yet, especially on Ryujinx, where vertex explosions occur, especially in the character swap menu, and there's low performance in some stages. The mod to enable 60 FPS will be available in the description, but it's important to note that the game won't always achieve that frame rate, although it runs with dynamic FPS, providing a smooth experience unless it drops below 30 FPS. For now, there's no reliable way to run this game on Android as it experiences vertex explosions, rendering issues, and low performance. Both emulators may experience delays during gameplay, resulting in moments where the game freezes for a few seconds, similar to a loading screen. The settings used for both projects will be available in the video description. With this information in mind, let's proceed to the tests on both emulators. In our first comparison, we chose an area with multiple enemies in a small arena to observe the game's performance. Both projects were running the game for the first time, so neither had any stored shaders. It became evident that shaders wouldn't be a problem right away. In recent tests, I noticed that Yuzu has become quite efficient in saving RAM in most games. Although I acquired 32 gigabytes of RAM to record and play with the emulator simultaneously, it's now noticeable that the consumption is only 10.9 gigabytes, compared to Ryujinx's 12.1 gigabytes. At this point, I observed that Ryujinx exhibits better performance, maintaining a higher frame rate most of the time. Check out the result of this test. Finally, we conducted the test in an open area, the only one available at the moment, with a large enemy on screen and various sand particle effects. This case is entirely different from the previous one. In Yuzu, we managed to keep the game above 30 FPS without causing slowdown. However, in Ryujinx, the game suffers several stutters and very low FPS, in some cases reaching as low as 15 FPS. Let's see the result. Before presenting my conclusion, please leave your like for more comparisons like this. And if this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to follow future updates on the latest emulators. In conclusion, due to vertex explosion issues and low FPS during some stages found on Ryujinx, currently, I recommend using Yuzu. Overall, you'll have a lower frame rate using Yuzu in simpler environments. However, when the emulator demands significant processing power, you won't feel that the game is slowing down, unlike Ryujinx, which will exhibit slowdowns and have more issues with shaders and other stutters. Hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time,